So exoskeletons are sort of the great unknown right now. They're primarily confined to research labs or locked behind proprietary doors. So what we want to do as a student team is open up exoskeletons to a wider audience.
Powered exoskeletons that use lithium batteries and pneumatic artificial muscles could maximize the performance of a future workforce. An undergraduate team at the University of Michigan, inspired by building their own Iron Man suit, created the first collegiate exoskeleton competition. Four other teams across the country accepted their challenge.
What we're interested in is exoskeletons for search and rescue applications, specifically for us firefighters, because we believe that if you can get someone into a dangerous situation with more energy, they can both make better decisions while they're in that dangerous situation, and if they really need to book it, they're gonna have more energy to do so.
This is the first collegiate exoskeleton competition. We know that people are actually coming. They're gonna bring something, and we'll be able to look at other people's designs. So even if they can't complete the obstacle course or their exoskeleton breaks or something like that, it's just the fact that we're getting people interested and that this is actually becoming something bigger. People are gonna be working out any bugs that they have with their exoskeletons.
Right side threshold's weird, but
lift your feet up.
We just kept running into issue after issue with the electronics and only got them sorted out at 4 a.m. last night.
It was really cool to see all the teams helping each other. I think all of us had so much fun. I think that has to be there. It's like a humanitarian project, so if you don't have that element, what are you doing here anyway?
We have a high torque motor on the back with the cable system routed through the bracket on the hip joint.
It's impressive. It's really impressive. We see a lot of crazy design. It's a lot of good crazy design.
I think someday this could really help do our job safer. If I could order one of these tomorrow, I would, because it would help our staff.
For the actual competition part, we're going to have the obstacle course, including walking across a balance beam, dragging a humanoid dummy.
3, 2, 1, go.
And then over what we're calling a, quote, rubble field. It's just gonna be like recyclable material that creates an uneven terrain. They're gonna have to walk up a set of steps.
We were supposed to have the motors running at our hip joints to help us climb up and down the stairs, but our control algorithm did not go that far. I had to use my own force to overcome the weight. Quite a challenge.
You know, this is the first one, so if it doesn't work this time, we'll do something different next year.
So we have tallied up all the scores. First, I want to say thank you to all of you guys for coming. Like, this has been awesome. We're really impressed with all the designs you made.
The winner of competition is by 0.09 points. It's a I don't know how you guys come to this point, probably the seconds who is running what. It is Colorado. Second place, Michigan University.
I think today went incredibly well. And despite everything going wrong and everything going to pieces, as every engineering project ever has, everything pulled through in the end, and we saw really, really great performance out of every exoskeleton. All we need to do is do it again, and again, and again.